Thanks, Cam Corlett. Taoiseach, on the same issue, yesterday I met somebody from the Termination for Medical Reasons group, and she asked me, what can they possibly do to influence your government to end this absolutely unacceptable, tragic situation that has been inflicted on many women in this country, where they become pregnant in a pregnancy that they want, with a child that they hope to have, only to discover the terrible fact that the child is suffering from a fatal foetal abnormality, a condition that is incompatible with life, and that that child has no chance of survival. And the current situation is, Taoiseach, that woman is forced to carry through a pregnancy that has no chance of survival, or go to Britain without support and have an abortion there, and in some cases leave their dead child in Britain, or in one appalling case, bring the child back in the boot of a car. In these awful, tragic, unbelievable circumstances. Are you seriously telling me that what you're telling that woman who talked to me last night, who said she had met several more people just in the last few months since the referendum, who'd gone through the same terrible circumstances she had, that you're going to do nothing? Nothing at all to end that tragedy? I find that absolutely beyond belief, I have to say, Taoiseach, and I would appeal to you to reconsider. And if you can't reconsider, can you just say, what should we say to those women? Can you answer that, Taoiseach? What should we say to those women? Can I also ask you, Taoiseach, in your discussions with church leaders, did you discuss the issue of poverty, which church leaders have been raising? Archbishop Dublin, of Dublin, Dermot Ryan, this year, for the first time since he took his position, issued in November an appeal for basic foodstuffs for thousands and thousands of people that are literally overwhelming the cross-care food banks, looking for food that they don't have enough of to provide for hungry people from all sorts of sectors of society. He described in his speech in the Pro Cathedral how children were going to school hungry and were unable to learn as a result, how university students were in dire straits, and that these things were as a result of the cuts, the austerity, the unemployment, the poverty that has increased dramatically as a result of austerity policies. So can I ask you, Taoiseach, did he raise these issues? And can I ask you honestly, are you not ashamed as the Taoiseach of this country that we have church leaders begging for food for the hungry of our society, and that coming into Christmas we are going to have more hungry people, more homeless people, more desperate people than we have ever had, probably since the 1920s or 30s in this country, and that you are presiding over the government where that is the case? I mean, is that not a matter of shame for this government and something that they should do something about?
Thank you. Taoiseach.
Well, the Constitution and the law say quite clearly what has to apply here in Ireland. And any woman is only entitled to a termination of a pregnancy where there is a threat to her life. And those are the circumstances which were explained in the law and which was the source of a great deal of discussion from experts of one sort or another and ordinary people all over the country. The enshrinement in law following very many years of doing nothing about it followed the endorsement of the people and the vote of the people for what they wanted put into the Constitution, and that's now reflected in the law. So the question of fatal foetal abnormalities is one that I hear myself on a regular basis, and it's obviously a matter of great sensitivity for the people involved. But I'm not in a position, Deputy Boyd Barrett, to determine absolutely a medical diagnosis as to whether a child will live or not. Nor are you.
Sorry, Deputy, would you please?
Yeah.
Thank
so
you.
Are,
sorry,
so,
I just say,
so are many other conditions that apply. If a pregnant mother is told that her child has a hole in the heart, is it likely that the child will die?
It's not likely, it's definite.
No, it's not.
Sorry, Deputy, please.
It's not.
No, Deputy. Deputy, Taoiseach, please continue, will you? Without interruption. Yeah, thank you.
All I want to say to Deputy Boyd Barrett, you're wrong in your assertion. And I'm not.
There are other deputies in the chamber, please.
The definition of a fatal foetal abnormality will depend upon the extent of the medical diagnosis. And medical diagnoses are not perfect no more than anything else in the world. So we disagree on that. So I've made my point here. In respect of poverty, this matter was raised by both groups, by both churches, in respect of the impact of the economic crisis and its impact on jobs and on families and all the rest of it. I don't think, Deputy Boyd Barrett, that you always put out the worst case possible. You swear your oath from listening to you that every person in the country was starving. Now, I commend all of those groups and all of those agencies and those organisations who do so much work for people who are suffering hardship and where there is a degree of poverty and hunger. And in a country like this, that shouldn't apply. And it's a case of us working with the agencies of government and the voluntary organisations and the families to see that their children are fed to the best in the best way possible. It shouldn't be in a country like Ireland in 2013 that any child should have to go to bed hungry. But unfortunately, that's the case in a number of cases. And that's why I think that the programmes that are done through schools and in communities and at breakfast clubs where these things are taken to hand by communities and by parents and by women in particular, and backed up by a lot of work from different agencies and everything, does have a really strong effect. I think communities have banded together far more effectively and far more closely, given the extent of what happened in the recession than before, where people assumed that everybody was well off and that everybody was a millionaire and that everybody had money for everything, when clearly that wasn't the case. And you know, and I know, there are some serious difficulties in many homes in the country, and where that applies, this is always a difficulty. It may be a case of an addiction, it may be a case of squandering money, it may be a case of not having any, and nobody wants to see that. So where these things are identified by many of the voluntary organisations, they do make a sterling effort to see that they're dealt with. I don't believe that anybody in our country in 2013, given the extent of what we produce, I should be hungry. We produce enough food to feed 35 million people. This is a case of understanding who needs it, in what circumstances, and how effectively you can deliver on that. And that's a very strong social requirement and social responsibility of government and its agencies to see that these problem areas are dealt with. And that where that's possible, and you change the whole nature of motivation, of interest, so that people can get into the world of work and better themselves, and as a consequence, provide in a better way for their children.
I have to say that in what is a very difficult and sensitive matter, you need to be informed about what you're talking about. Edwards syndrome, Hathouse syndrome, fatal foetal abnormalities, conditions, there's no debate, there's no dispute, there's no controversy. The view of doctors is absolutely conclusive, definitive and uncontested. With those syndromes, we are talking about conditions that are incompatible with life. I know this, among other things, Taoiseach, because I had a daughter who was born with one of these conditions, and it is a very difficult thing to get your head around to know that a child that is born or is yet to be born has a condition that is incompatible with life. No chance of life. Can't live. So there's no dispute. It's not similar to other conditions where a child might or might not live. The child can't live. And the mother is informed the child can't live. And then the question is, must she be forced to go through with a pregnancy in a situation where the child can't live? And if she makes the decision she cannot do that, be forced to go to Britain to have an abortion? Or will she be looked after, nurtured and protected in this most appalling of circumstances, where a wanted pregnancy cannot conclude with a life? And what the people who have been victims of this terrible situation are asking you is, if necessary, to amend the Constitution to allow for terminations in these circumstances.
Thank you.
And I can't believe, Taoiseach, you are seriously telling these women and the many, many who will face the same situation every week, every week. Genetic abnormalities like this throw themselves out roughly 1 in 10,000 pregnancies.
Thanks very much, Sabine.
Are you going to tell, for years to come, women in this appalling situation, there's nothing I can do?
Thank you.
You must be forced to go through this terrible tragedy and the state will do nothing for you. I can't believe you are seriously saying that, Taoiseach. If necessary, you must amend the Constitution, although there's some legal opinion to the effect that you could do it within the current constitutional framework, because we are not talking about the termination of a life that is viable. And therefore, seriously, Taoiseach, meet these women. If you don't understand the condition, meet
the women and meet the doctors who know about it.
Please offer them some hope.
Taoiseach.
The question I was asked by Deputy Higgins was it my intention to amend the legislation in this matter, and I said it wasn't my intention to do that. And while I recognise that these things are very sensitive, you always go from what you describe as certainty to areas where there is uncertainty. And medical diagnosis cannot determine accurately in cases where the might or the maybe or the uncertainty actually exists. I've already said to Deputy Higgins it's not my intention to introduce legislation to amend the situation that applies.
Thank you.
As you referred to.
That completes questions to Taoiseach.